St. Paul. This is Reverend Buford. I pray that you have had a great past week and that this week coming up will be better than the last. Last week, though, I pray each of you had a great week. We experienced some victories and we experienced a little bit of terror. First off, Georgia is blue. Okay, for the first time, Georgia is blue. And there are quite a few people who cannot believe that Georgia is blue. We voted Democratic in the presidential election in November, and January 5th, we also voted blue. We voted in Reverend Raphael Warnock and John Ossoff into two open Georgia Senate seats. So claps to everyone who went out, everyone who went out and voted, everyone who registered someone to vote, everybody who dragged somebody to the polls to vote. Kudos to you. We did what we needed to do. On the day of victory and history, we experienced mayhem at the Capitol during the time period where we were supposed to be, or the Senate was supposed to be, solidifying the presidential election. We just need to go into prayer warriors, go into your closets, prayers, just pray for this country, pray for this land. We need healing, we need unity, we need so much. We need love, we need the blood of Jesus to just be poured out upon each and every citizen of the United States of America. There are other nations coming to the U.S.'s defense saying this is not like them. It's just mayhem. We just need to pray. We prayed for the victory. We need to now pray for order and peace amongst each other. Political parties should not divide us this much as a people. They should not. But in this season, we are being divided more than ever due to political parties and negativity coming from just a man who can't accept defeat. But either way, I just want to let everybody know we need to go into deep prayer. In your prayer time, just remember to pray for the United States, the incoming administration, those two Senate seat holders now, Reverend Warnock and John Ossoff. Pray for them because the battles, I believe, are just beginning. We have a few announcements, and the first announcement goes to Pastor's anniversary. We will be celebrating 15 years of Reverend Stegall being at St. Paul. And that service will be held Sunday, January 17th at 1 p.m. 1 p.m. I'm going to say it again. January 17th. Don't miss it. 1 p.m. via Facebook and YouTube. Remember, these are just a few reminders. We're in the new year and a lot of things have changed. But there are a few things that have stayed the same. And that is that prayer service is held every third Friday at 7 p.m. Bible study is every Wednesday at 7 p.m. Via Zoom. Don't forget about Sunday school, held every single Sunday at 10 a.m. And women's Bible study held every second Saturday except for this Saturday at 9 a.m. This past Saturday at 9 a.m. There are four ways, there's possibly more ways, so there are ways to give, and we should be excited about just having the opportunity to give back. First is Tithely. You can log on to your Google Play Store, your Apple App Store, and you can download that app and pay your tithe the way that I do. You can text GIVE to 844-208-5586. You can definitely do it the old-fashioned way and you can mail it in. There is nothing wrong with that. Mail it into P.O. Box 2066, Covington, Georgia 30015. Or if you don't want to do any of the three above, you can just simply drop it off and it's perfectly fine. There are a few announcements that are going to roll past your screen, a few flyers. The DMC, we are looking for Debs and Masters to participate in this year's Debutante and Masters Commission. If you are interested in the slightest bit, please let me know. You can either email me or you can call me, Reverend Buford, and I will send you the application and I'll send you the list of activities that we will be doing. Secondly, every person who is a part of the congregation can definitely participate in this activity. We are going to be giving back. We are going to be giving back to the community, to the homeless, to the homeless shelter. We are going to be putting together toiletry bags. We are going to be collecting blankets. We are going to be going up to Big Bethel on the 18th, I do believe, at 10 a.m. to feed the homeless, to give those toiletry bags that will be made on that day to the homeless. But my prayer is that you, whatever is laid on your heart, if you have it, that you would be able to donate any items or even funds to this cause. That's underneath also the DMC, but it's for everyone to do. In the wake of COVID, a lot of things have kind of maybe fallen by the wayside, and this is just an opportunity for us as God's people to give back to God's people who are less fortunate than we are. And the order of service is as follows. After the sound of my voice, you will hear Reverend Edmonds, who will do the opening prayer, Sister Ali, who will read the scripture, and then the offertory prayer will be done by Reverend Smith. And then you will hear a preached word from our esteemed pastor, Reverend Thomas R. Stegall. And then we will be closing out. So I just pray that you pray for our country, pray for our homeless, pray for each other. Love and unity. Amen.
Good morning, St. Paul. It is with great pleasure that I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. On this wonderful day that we get together to serve Him in spirit and in truth, let us pray. Most holy and gracious Father, it is once again that we come together to lift you up in song and praise, and that we can pray to you, Heavenly Father, knowing that you are the only true and living God. For this, Lord, we come before you humbly as we ask you, Lord, to forgive us of anything that we may have said, thought, or done that's not pleasing in your sight, that you, Lord, will extend to us that grace and great mercy that you allow for us each and every day of our lives. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for the many wonderful blessings that you have bestowed upon us. Thank you, Heavenly Father, because even for the simple things in our lives, whether it be food, clothing, or a roof over our head, we say thank you, Heavenly Father, for being able to come together in your name. Heavenly Father, we realize that right now we are going through a period of pandemic. But Heavenly Father, we know that you have the power to heal, the power to protect, the power over it all. And regardless, Lord, of the effects to our bodies, we know that no pandemic can touch our souls. And it is our souls that worship, and it is our souls that give you praise. Heavenly Father, we ask that you continue to bless and keep us. Allow us, Heavenly Father, to have the strength and strength that we desire, Lord, so that we can praise your mighty name. Heavenly Father, we come before you asking that you give help and strength to the leader of this flock, that he, Lord, will be able to continue to teach and to preach in your mighty name. Bless his wife, Heavenly Father, his helpmeet, the one that is able to give him, Lord, any assistance that he might require as she goes forth serving you in spirit and in truth. Heavenly Father, we ask all these things, Lord, that will come to us, that it be in your holy name. For it is in the name of Jesus Christ that we pray. Amen, amen, and amen.
Hello, everyone. It's so nice to be here with you today. I come to you with the scriptures from the teaching of Jesus Christ on the mountainside as he taught his disciples. You may find this teaching in its entirety in Matthew chapter 5, and I'm going to recite verse 8 to you. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. May the Lord bless you, and this brings me to the end of this scripture reading.
Good morning, St. Paul, as we prepare to go to the preached word. The topic this morning is the work is all divine. And I remember how Paul had to call and write and encourage Timothy, telling him that the work is all divine. So this morning, as we exhort on this one particular scripture, let's study it in detail away from the sermon. God bless you. God keep you. Keep loving on one another. Stay safe. In Jesus' name, our sermon is coming up. Amen.
Good morning, St. Paulinians. It is indeed good to be in the house of the Lord one more time, where we have been spared another week. Excuse me, another day to praise your holy and righteous name. Every time I think about the goodness of the Lord, my soul cries out hallelujah, and I know yours does too, because God has been so good to us, and we just want to thank him and bless his holy name. At this time, it's giving time, a time to give back to the Lord a portion, just a portion of that which he's already given to us. Isn't it interesting how God gives us 100% and only requires 10%? He gives us not 90% to do just about anything we want to do with that is pleasing unto him. So at this time, we would ask that wherever you are, we've already been given the ways to give. So we just ask that you would take whatever you have. Even if you don't have it, just lift up your hands unto the Lord and just give praise. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come right now thanking you once again for life, health, and strength as reasonable as it is. Lord, we ask you to look down upon our offerings, our tithes, and our blessings that you have already given us, to bless them, O Lord, to bless them that they be used for the kingdom of your building here on earth, that your storehouse may be full, that your people may be recipients of what you have given us. And, O Lord, increase our faith to give you, O God, not just only in the money and the funds, but in our time and our service to do that which is pleasing to you. Oh, Lord, continue to make a way out of no way. We know a lot of us are without jobs. A lot of us are unemployment. A lot of us have lost our benefits. But God, we look to you from whence cometh our help. Because we know that our help cometh from the Lord who made the heavens and the earth. The earth is the Lord and the fullness there is. And Lord, we just thank you. And we praise you right now. In the name of Jesus, let this house never be in need, oh God, that all of our desires, all of our wants are fulfilled in your sight. We give you glory, we give you honor and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
But hold on, better days are coming.
Greetings, St. Paul. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. This morning, I'd like to speak with you concerning situations that have taken place in our country the past 3 days. Instead of there being a peaceful transition, a counting of the electoral votes, our Capitol was under siege. And when I began to watch the thing as it unfolded, it reminded me of how that same type of turmoil, if we're not careful, can come into the church. So this morning, I want to exalt on a scripture, Paul, when he was telling Timothy, when turmoil was creeping into the church and Paul was in prison and Timothy was on his own. I want to go to 1 Timothy 3, the 16th verse. And when you get there, you'll find these words. And without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness, small g. God was manifest in the flesh, justified in the spirit, seen of the angels, preached unto the nations, believed on the word, received up to glory. Every now and then when I look at that scripture, it reminds me that Paul was trying to tell Timothy, there are going to be some dark days, but we as children of God got to carry ourselves a certain way. Come on, let us pray. God, we thank you for another day's journey, how the rains come, but you shelter us from the rain, how the enemy camps outside our door, but you keep the enemy at bay. God, how you have put food on our table and clothes on our back and shelter over our heads. God, we thank you this morning because when the storms do come, you're in the storms with us. So right now, God, open our ears, open our eyes, open our hearts so that we may apply them to wisdom and do what is pleasing in your sight. Just have your way in Jesus' name. Amen. 1 Timothy is a beautiful piece of work. 1 Timothy is a beautiful piece of work. Paul's instructing his young colleague on how troubles are going to come, but he tells him in that very first verse, that 16th verse, that verse stanza, he said, and without controversy, great is the mystery of godliness. In other words, he was telling him, there are going to be some dark days, there are going to be some days that trouble is going to come your way. Not anything that you've done wrong, it's just going to come. But we, being children of God, must carry ourselves in a certain way. We cannot act like the world act. Although we're in the world, we cannot act like the world. I saw individuals flying American flags talking about Save America, but yet tearing up one of the most iconic symbols of our democracy. That just blew my mind. Just like individuals in the church saying they love God, but yet and still they go out and hate their neighbor, saying they love God, but when they see their neighbor needs bread, they tell him, let him get his own, saying they love God. But yet and still, when it's time to show their godliness, their kindness, their love for their brother man, they turn their back and go the other way. Now, I know this ain't nothing new. This ain't nothing new. Watch. There was an individual coming down the Jericho Road, and one day he fell among thieves, and when he fell fell among thieves, guess what? The priest came along, looked at him, went to the other side. So ain't nothing new. And then here come a Samaritan, came over and gave him what he needed, put him in the inn. Every now and then, those who you think are religious ain't all that religious. So don't be shocked when the ones that you hold in high esteem don't uphold that high esteem status. Amen. They don't uphold that high esteem status. So this morning, I'm looking at how Paul told Timothy, God was manifested in the flesh. That helped him to know that God did not just sit high. He came down low. He made himself a body wrapped in the form of a human man called Jesus. And he walked among us, helping us to understand that he is real. And I like that old song the saints used to sing, real, real. Jesus is real to me. Oh, yes. He gives me the victory. So therefore, when you having to be godly and have a spirit of giving and a spirit of love and the world around you is acting all crazy, don't worry about it. Jesus had to put up with it too. Then when you find yourself wanting to do the right thing and those that you're trying to do the right thing for ain't trying to let you be right, don't worry about it. They did Jesus the same way. He didn't come to condemn, but he came that we might be saved. He didn't come to bring war, but he came that we might have peace. He didn't come to destroy our joy. He came that we might have joy more abundantly. Yeah, he came. And now Paul is having to explain this to Timothy. Yes, he is. Timothy, don't worry about it. Timothy, don't worry about it. It's going to be trouble, but it's going to be all right. He goes on to tell him in that 16th verse of that third chapter, justified in the spirit. We say we are children of God. We pray that God keeps us and holds us even in the midst of our tribulations. So this morning, we're going to have to learn to walk in the spirit of God. Sometimes it ain't easy. Sometimes walking in the spirit of God, death is right at your door. Sometimes walking in the spirit of God, your enemies take advantage of you. Sometimes walking in the spirit of God, you'll find that your friends will turn their backs on you. Sometimes walking in the spirit of God, but that trouble don't last always. No. Trouble don't last always. Why? Because Paul had already told Timothy. He came. He was in the flesh. So when you are in trouble, realize God is right there too. When you are in the storm, he might bring you to the storm. And when he brings you to the storm, he'll put you through the storm. And if he puts you through the storm, he'll bring you out of the storm. So don't worry about it. God is right there with you. He goes on to tell Timothy, the angels will bear witness. Then he tells him, preach unto the nations. So Timothy, the angels bear witness that he is the Son of God, but he had to preach to the nations anyway. So there are going to be some days that the people you're preaching to by your witness ain't going to receive your witness, but you preach anyway. They're going to be the days you reach out your hand in glad friendship and it's going to be rejected. You reach out anyway. It's going to be some days when you think just because you come in the name of the Lord, the people going to receive you. They're going to reject you. You reach out in his name anyway. Jesus came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. But he also gave us a mission and a ministry. Yours may not be preaching from the pulpit. Yours may not be standing at the door on Sunday morning. Yours may not be being a trustee, keeping the house of God in its right order. Yours may not be a steward where you labor with the pastor or the leader trying to make sure that everyone gets a fair shake in the house of the Lord. But yours is to let your light shine. Somebody, let your light shine. Let your light shine. They, somebody may see Jesus in you. This morning, when I think about what Paul was telling Timothy, trouble gonna come. And trouble's gonna have to go. We are to carry ourselves in a way that the world will always see Jesus in us. We are to walk in the pathway of duty. When we look over our lives and can see how God has brought us through, then it ought to be a little easier for us to hold our heads up in the midst of a storm. When we look over our lives and see how the world hadn't been fair to us, we ought to look over our lives and see how God has brought us through in spite of the hard times, how God has kept us in spite of the shortcomings of our situations. I'm glad this morning that when we avail ourselves to God, He avails Himself to us. I'm glad this morning. It's a new day, and each and every day God gives us a new day. He gives us new mercies. I'm glad this morning. It's a new year, and last year is gone. The only thing we can do about it is look back and learn and not make the same mistakes. Well, I gotta leave you now. Just three quick points. First, in the midst of all that's going on in your life, Paul had to tell Timothy, don't worry about it, you keep the faith. It ain't gonna be easy, but you keep the faith. It ain't gonna be simple. You're gonna have to work at it. You're gonna have to pray when you don't feel like praying. You're gonna have to sing when you don't feel like singing. You're gonna have to shout in the middle of a hard time. People gonna look at you like you're crazy. Why he shouting when you ought to be crying? Secondly, if you keep order, your order is get up in the morning with Jesus on your mind. Your order is call him during the noonday hour. Your order is call him in the evening before you lay down to go to sleep. If you keep your life in order, he will order your steps. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. And knowing that every now and then you got to go down on bended knees. Maybe you don't have no knees. You can still bow your head. Thirdly, keep the faith. It's going to be hard sometime, but keep the faith. God knows what you're going through. Keep the faith. Timothy had to be told and he had to be encouraged. And when I think about how Paul constantly had to write to Timothy and encourage him, his first and second letter, every so often we ought to look into the Gospels and see how God encourages us. He encouraged us to love folks that don't love you. He encouraged us to walk with peace rather than a war stick. Come on, he encourages us to love everybody. He encourages us, just like Paul encouraged Peter. Last but not least, you got to be faithful. It ain't easy sometimes, but you got to be faithful. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. Man will change on you. Your monies will run out. Your friends will turn their backs. Hard times will come. Dark days will overshadow the good ones. But you got to stay faithful. We're in a pandemic. Our church has been closed now going on 10 months. Got to stay faithful. Call your neighbor. Call your friends. Tell them don't give up. Trouble don't last always. We got to stay faithful. All I want you to know today, what Paul was telling Timothy, the work is all divine. The work is all divine. Let's pray. God, have your way. Realizing that the work is all divine. We've come a long way carrying our burdens in the heat of the day. We've come over rocks and reels. We come up high, the rough side of the mountain, but the work is still all divine. We've had some good days. We've had some weary days. We had some sleepless nights, but God, the work is still all divine. So bless us now. Help us to know that the storm don't last always, and behind every storm there is a silver lining. Encourage us to keep loving on one another. Encourage us to keep doing good when it seems like nothing is coming of our effort. Help us, God. Get in us. Be with us. have your way in Jesus' name. Amen.